إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد. Alhamdulillah, brothers and sisters, we are just a few days away from the beginning of the days of Dhul-Hijjah. Inshallah, Wednesday, the 22nd of July, is expected to be the first of these blessed 10 days, the 10 days about which the Prophet ﷺ said that there are no days in which doing good deeds is worth more than in these 10 days. And these are blessed days of Ayyamul Hajj. This is one of the pillars of Islam. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remove this trial from us, inshallah, to open up the doors of the Haramain once again. And so we can have this act of worship being performed by the millions of people that once used to come for the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Worship in and of itself is of at least three different types in our religious practice as Muslims in Islam. So either our worship is made up of something verbal, dhikr, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, takbirat, etc. Either it's something physical, combination of verbal and physical, or just purely something physical, like salah or fasting, which is a purely physical form of ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or our acts of worship are financial, meaning we're spending money. And so our zakat, our sadaqah, etc., different acts of worship incorporate kind of different or emphasize different aspects or different areas of how we express our ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Hajj is the pillar of Islam. Hajj is the pillar of Islam where all of these come together in one major act of worship. So you have the dhikr of Allah, the verbal worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being made. The hujjaj in Hajj are saying labbaik Allahumma labbaik. Those of us that are not at Hajj, we have an established takbirat, you know, from the fajr of the day of Arafah until the Asr prayer of the 13th of Dhul-Hijjah. 5 days after every prayer, we are encouraged to do the takbirat as the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So whether you're at Hajj or whether you're not, this is a time to engage in verbal ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is the physical ibadah as well. For those who are at Hajj, they are sacrificing their energies by making sure they're performing their rituals properly. They're having to pray on time. They're having to go from place to place. And those of us who are not at Hajj, we are still supposed to carry ourselves, making sure we're fulfilling our prayers, our salawat. There's fasting that is involved as well. For those at Hajj, if they can't afford an animal to sacrifice, then there's fasting that has been prescribed. For those of us not at Hajj, the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the highly encouraged sunnah of fasting at least on the day of Arafah, the 9th of Dhul-Hijjah, which is likely to be a Thursday this year, inshallah. Again, fasting on that day, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it forgives the previous year's worth of sins and the next year's worth of sins. A highly high act of worship. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow all of us to achieve it. And then again, there's a financial aspect to this time. Those that make the journey have to finance that journey. They have to finance the animals that are going to be sacrificed. And those of us not at Hajj, again, a sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, an encouraged sunnah, that we finance an animal to be slaughtered, a portion at least, if not the whole animal, but a portion at least being given to the poor and the needy as a form of charity in this time. So these days that are coming up are going to be a combination of all different types of worship tied to one of the pillars of Islam. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to make the most of these days. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam specifically said about the day of Arafah, ما من يوم أكثر من أن يعتق الله فيه عبد من النار من يوم عرفه, that there is no day in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala frees more people from the hellfire than on the day of Arafah, the day on which the people will be standing on the plain of Arafah making dua to Allah. It's a day of dua, and just because we are not there doesn't mean we don't partake in the dua. We can make the dua ourselves as well. And again, fasting on that day is a prescribed sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he continued, he says, وَإِنَّهُ لَيَدْنُ لَيَدْنُ ثُمَّ يُبَاهِ بِهِمَ الْمَلَائِكَ فَيَقُولُ مَا أَرَادَ هَؤُلَاءَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes near to the people on the day of Arafah. And he prides himself in front of the angels and he says, what is it that these people want? What is it that they are asking for so that their du'as can be answered? And again, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is found even in these days. Allah Azza wa Jalla tells us about Hajj, walillahi ala nasi hajjul bayti man istata'a ilayhi sabila, that Hajj is an obligation. Everybody has to do it, but those who can find a way. If you cannot find a way to fulfill that obligation financially, physically, etc., then you have an exemption. And this is a principle that's going to come in very handy. There's an announcement we have to make after Salah. So inshallah, please stick around 1 minute after Salah about an announcement for Jumu'ah next week as well. But the purpose of this Hajj season is to show gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And interestingly enough, for something we may consider very simple. Sometimes even insignificant, and we may not think about it to the full extent. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍّ عَمِيقٍ لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ وَيَذْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهِ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْلُومَاتٍ عَلَى مَا رَزَقَهُمْ مِنْ بَهِيمَةِ الْأَنْعَامِ فَكُلُوا مِنْهَا وَأَطْعِمُوا الْبَائِسَ الْفَقِيرَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and proclaim to the people the Hajj, the pilgrimage. They will come to you on foot, on every animal, and they will come from every distant pass, that they may be witnesses to the benefits that they have received, that they may witness the benefits they have for themselves, and that they may mention the name of Allah in these known days, these 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, over what He has provided for them of these sacrificial animals. So eat of them and feed the needy and the poor. There's something specifically about praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the blessing of Him facilitating this process of us getting nutrition. Nutrition specifically through these animals that provide us meat. And this is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants every nation to be grateful for. He says subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلِكُلِّ أُمَّةٍ جَعَلْنَا مَنْسَكًا لِيَذْكُرُوا اسْمَ اللَّهِ عَلَى مَا رَزَقَهُمْ مِنْ بَهِيمَةِ الْأَنْعَامِ. He says, for every ummah, we gave them a ritual in order to mention the name of Allah over what He has provided them of these sacrificial animals. فَإِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهُ وَاحِدٌ فَلَهُ أَسْلِمُ وَبَشِّرِ الْمُخْبِتِينَ. And your God is one God. So submit to Him. And then give glad tidings to those that are humble. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly mentions the blessing of meat, of these animals, with the fact that your Lord is one, your God is one. And this is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us specifically to be grateful for. And you can think about it and ponder about it after Jumu'ah as well, inshallah. What is it about this blessing, that these animals that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided for us, that specifically He wants us to be grateful for? Specific rules about how we slaughter our animals, how we treat the animals at the time of slaughter. Very, very specific rules that we have and we have to be mindful of, especially in this time if you're going to slaughter. But special rules we have to be mindful for. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, when you are eating of this meat, you are enjoying a direct benefit and ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He made these creatures in a way that they would submit themselves to you for you to consume. Otherwise, how would we have been able to make these animals, some of them huge, submit on our own? But it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that ingrains in these animals this quality that they submit for the purpose of being eaten to provide you nutrition. Every time you have a meal, you are directly engaged in a blessing. You are getting the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah azza wa jalla wants us to appreciate that blessing, and He wants us to share that blessing. وَأَطْعِمُ الْبَائِسَ الْفَقِيرِ. Feed the poor, feed the needy, appreciate the food that you have as well. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to really appreciate the blessings of this time, to take the time out to make sure that we schedule our ibadah in these 10 days, that we fast on the day of Arafah, that we sacrifice an animal or give money to, for that animal to be sacrificed anywhere in the world that may need it as well, wherever you can afford, inshallah. But partake in every single type of worship, verbal, physical, financial, that you can in these 10 days. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us and give us these blessings through His ibadah. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ ذَنْبٍ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. عباد الله إن الله أمرنا بالصلاة والسلام على النبي فقال إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم على عبدك ورسولك نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين وأعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم اجعلنا مجتمعين على الحق غير متفرقين فيه واغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولجميع المؤمنين عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقيموا الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
لا إله إلا الله استغفر. Please, if you can, stick around just for 1 minute after the prayer. There's an important announcement about Jummah next week.
Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Maliki Yawmiddin Iyaka Na'budu Wa Iyaka Nasta'in Ihdina الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين والتين والزيتون وطور سينين وهذا البلد الأمين لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن تقويم ثم رددناه أسفل سافلين إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات فلهم أجر غير ممنون فما يكذبك بعد بالدين أليس الله بأحكم الحاكمين الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين أرأيت الذي يكذب بالدين فذلك الذي يدعو اليتيم ولا يحض على طعام المسكين فويل للمصلين الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون الذين هم يراءون ويمنعون الماعون الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. If you didn't hear already in our town hall that we had on Thursday, the Atlanta Muslim community has been having a shura where we keep updated as to what's happening with the virus and the dangers associated with it. Alhamdulillah, we have Muslims that are working with the CDC, working directly with the virus, and also treating patients, etc. And so as part of this shura we had on Wednesday night, if you're not already familiar, Masjid Farooq has already had to close down for Jum'ah. Masjid Umar has closed down for Jum'ah. I think ECIC also had to close down because of some cases in the community as well. And so considering the high number of cases and hospitalizations that are happening right now, they're much higher than they were initially when we had made the decision to close the masjid. We are from next week going to go to only one Jum'ah salah instead of three. And that's after the shura, after consulting with our experts and making these decisions with our board as well. We're going to go down to one Jum'ah because again, it's short of closing the masjid. It's the least amount of risk that we're assuming for our community. Your staff members, we have at least five staff members that are here from at least, you know, for over 3 hours every Friday. And as people are coming and going, your staff is exposed as well to over 100 people. And again, if anything happens in that interaction and then more community members are coming in, it just puts the entire community at a higher risk. So the lowest risk short of closing the masjid down right now is just to go to one Jum'ah. And so from next week, the only session we'll have is the 1:45 to 2 p.m. session. We're going to brainstorm over the weekend, inshallah, about how to accommodate people. We're going to have the same number that we can accommodate. So we're only going to be accommodating a very limited number per Jum'ah. But we're going to try to come up with some solution, inshallah, to where if maybe someone comes 1 week, other people can come the other week. We're going to try to see if we can accommodate that, inshallah. But also as community members yourselves, you know, we can all make that step to say, if I come 1 week, maybe I can skip the next week so that somebody else can come in place. The ayah I mentioned about Hajj, that Hajj is an obligation for those who can find a way. And so for anyone that can't be accommodated in the masjid due to the size, the limit, etc., what's an obligation on them is to pray their Dhuhr Salah wherever they are, inshallah, at home, at work, or wherever. But if you can't make it to Jum'ah, you would pray your Dhuhr Salah. So again, from next week, inshallah, just one Jum'ah prayer, 1:45 to 2 p.m. Check our website, put your email in, our social media, for updates on what the process will be, inshallah ta'ala. Jazakumullah khair, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala return us back to normal.